What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Cigars and Whiskey for our next review. Today's review is going to be a cigar that has been out since 2018. It was released at the trade show there, but it has just finally reached Stag Tobacconist in Metro, one of the first shops I've seen it in the Phoenix area. Now, it might be the fact that the shop just got it or the fact that they've been sitting on a waiting list. Truth would be unknown to me of why they finally got it in 2019. But again, sometimes those cigars people are looking for are way on back order, and you just gotta wait. So with that said, we're gonna get into it. And the cigar that I'm featuring is the Gurkha Marquesa. I don't know if I'm saying it right. If I'm not saying it right, I know, I'm a dumb gringo. I can't speak Spanish to save my life. But the cigar itself features a Sumatran wrapper, and the binder and filler is all Nicaraguan as far as the binder filler. Now, it does feature two different regions within Nicaragua in that wrapper, and it does come in a 6x54, a 6x52, and I believe the other one is the Bellicoso, which I think is a 5x52, if I'm not mistaken. But we're going to be smoking today the 6x54, the Toro, and there's about 20 per box, and so you're looking at roughly, they're saying $8 to $10, depending on the size. They're saying that if you want a box of the Toros, it'd run you about $180. Now, I did find it cheaper than what, you know, what the website says that the pricing is. All right, so with that said, we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna cut this up and get into that pre-draw. All right, everybody, into the pre-draw of our cigar. And I did use a straight cut for that. Right off the bat, we're getting a chocolate cocoa. It's a little bit of a dried fruit profile. Now, that you might hear that in a lot of my reviews, and that's just because I believe, in my opinion, in my head, and the way my reviews are for cigars from Nicaragua, they all have similar profiles. Gotta say though, the pre-draw is fabulous on this cigar. It's not too firm, it's not real spongy, it's got a little bit of a give, but the draw is phenomenal. And I will go ahead and we're gonna light this up. I'm gonna use a torch. I'm gonna give it a custody torch here. And we're gonna get right into the first third. In that first third, I am getting like a dark espresso, a dark earth profile. There's a little bit of sweetness and it lingers on the back of the palate after you've finished exhaling all the smoke and you're just like in between puffs. I gotta say though, it's a tasty stick, and for something that's supposed to be close to pre-embargo cigars from Cuba, I don't know. I'm not old enough to say I've had the Cubans, and I haven't actually ever smoked a Cuban. That doesn't mean I won't. I just have never had the opportunity to be given one or bought one and try, which I'm assuming sometime in my life that'll happen. But there is a real rich earthiness to the cigar. It isn't like too complicated, excuse me, it's not too complicated, but it is straightforward with its profiles. But with that said, we'll keep puffing away, get through the first third, get in the second third, and I'll let you know what that is like in just a bit. All right, everybody, welcome back to the start of the second third of our review of the Gurkha Marquesa. As you can see, the cigar's ash is holding pretty good. The burn isn't razor sharp. The profiles from the beginning, I said, were as like a sweet hay, cocoa. Now I'm getting a little more of the leather, a little more hearty flavor, like a nut, maybe a walnut or a cashew profile. But I can honestly say it's a very, it's a very mild Gurkha. For some people, they say Gurkhas are a little stronger than they like. I like stronger cigars, but I'd have to say this is a good cigar. I'd keep in the humidor. This would be something I would recommend. And I've seen some other YouTubers recommend the same thing. And after trying it and thinking about it, I would agree. This would be a cigar I would recommend for those who like mild cigars but want to try to go to a little stronger cigar, but not going too overboard. This might be a good transition cigar for you. Like I said, the price point's between 7 and 10, depending on where you look for it. You know, they're saying, the manufacturer says $9, so that's about the middle you're going to find. But I honestly got to say, it's a really good cigar. I like the size. I like the Toro size, the 6x54. Go ahead and take that ash off now. It's starting to get ready to fall. But all in all, I'd say it's a decent cigar going through the second third. As we're getting through that, though, like I said, getting a little more of a leather profile, more of that nut profile. The grasses are kind of there. The pepper's there, but it's not really overpowering. It's there initially when you finish taking a puff of the cigar, a little bit of this, a little of the spiciness in the back. But with that said, we're going to keep going at it, and I'll be back with the final third and my final thoughts of our review after this. All right, everybody, into the final third of our cigar. As you can see, it's still burning it's getting a little bit better burn. The ash does fall off, so you got to be careful with that. But with that said, the profiles really haven't changed that much. In the final third, they're the same as the first and second. But all in all, it is a good stick. The price point, I think, is great for what it is. Like I said before, I do think this is going to be more of a crossover cigar for those who want to go from lighter cigars more to a little bit stronger cigars, but not too much that it makes them not like them at all. But with that said, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked it, give me a thumbs up, hit that subscribe and like button. Again, thanks for tuning in to Cigars and Whiskey. Have a great day, have a great smoke, and I will see you next time.